What's going on, everybody? It's Eric Rayweather back here, and in today's video, I'm going to be showing you a very nice, simple money play that you can use to just dink and dunk your way down the field against all the popular coverages, pretty much, you know, the typical stuff you're going to see when you're playing the game. And if they start to kind of overcommit to you, then you're going to open up some bigger stuff down the field as well. So I'm in the Steelers playbook today, switching it up a little bit because I've been getting some requests to do some Steelers playbook stuff. So we're going to look at the gun tight doubles formation. I believe this is only in the Steelers playbook. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm pretty sure it's just in the Steelers playbook. And the play we want to look at is the flood drive. Like I said, you know, all your basic type of coverages, cover three, cover two, man, that you're going to see. This is going to be super simple, whether you're a beginner or you're a little bit more of an advanced player. Very simple way to just dink and dunk your way down the field. So, want to take the running back and want to block him just for some extra protection. And then we take the X receiver and put him on an in route, and we're going to motion snap him out. And what we're looking for, first and foremost, every time are the underneath routes, the drag and the in route. It's basically a mesh concept underneath. This is what we're looking for every time. You know, pick up 5, 6, 7 yards. And you move on to the next play. In my opinion, especially the past couple of years, this is the best way, you know, for the average person online, this is going to be the best way to play offense. It's low risk. It's, you know, it's low reward, but it's also low risk. You know, you're dinking, dunking. You're saying, you know, every two plays, I'm getting a first down if I just hit the open man. It, you know, it doesn't take a lot of time for any of these routes to develop. Even the corner route, we're going to show that in a little bit. That corner route is, you know, it's a really quick developing corner route. It develops very fast. And it's just a very simple way to play the game. You're not having to do too much thinking. You're not having to make all these crazy reads all over the field. You're basically focusing on one area of the field. And if the defense is clamped down on that, you go to your second read and that's it. But for the most part, the way people play this game, you know, you're going to have the underneath stuff all the time. Even if they send like a blitz, you know, some people might want to blitz off the edge or blitz one of the linebackers. You know, we have the running back blocking, which, you know, helps us get a little bit more protection. But again, I mean, you're still hitting the same thing. And then if anything, you're in better shape if they blitz when you're running this type of a, you know, underneath mesh concept, because you're throwing it where they're blitzing from. So they're just kind of opening it up more for you. You just have to be maybe a little bit quicker at getting the ball out, but that's it. Now, let's say, you know, some people might shade underneath. They say, okay, you're dink and dunking them, they're going to shade underneath. Well, with this play, what I like about that first and foremost is even if they shade underneath, you're still going to have the X receiver open underneath. It's going to be a little bit smaller of a window where, you know, when they didn't shade underneath, we were getting maybe like 7 yards pretty typically. Whereas if they shade underneath, you're looking more at 5. But you're still, like I said, 5 yards a pop is what you're looking for, because that's getting you a first down every two plays. You see, we shaded underneath, and that took away the drag over here. But this hook zone right here, where Telvin Smith, he's still kind of respecting the tight end and having to lurk where the tight end is. And he starts to come down when he sees the in route come underneath. But it's too late. We're already at about the 4-yard mark. And typically, we're going to get 5 here. You know, we got a good animation, so we got some extra, which was fine, but typically you're gonna get 5. So that's one thing I like about this, is even when they shade underneath to try to take that away, you can still hit one of those routes. Now you say, okay, well, what if they shade underneath and just were to use her that route? Okay, let's say for instance they take, let's say they're using this linebacker, right? I'm gonna man him up on X to simulate a user, and this is just where it's, you know, cat and mouse game. So if the user were to come down on that, well, then that's leaving this open over the middle. So the user still has to pick, because that in route's coming open regardless. So you put the user in no man's land there. Okay, do you want to clamp down underneath? If I see you clamp down, I can go high and go to the tight end. But what you also can do when they shade underneath is you have the corner out for a huge gain. Now, if I know they're shading underneath, if I recognize it, this is where I'm trying to go. And you see how it's such a quick corner. It cuts very quickly, gets to the outside very quickly. That's good, because some corner routes take a little bit longer to develop, and that could leave you, you know, prone to getting sacked. This one develops so quick. You just take one step up in the pocket, you deliver this pass, and then you're in a situation where a lot of times you're going to be able to make that first guy miss, because the jukes and spins are so overpowered. Anytime you're on the sideline on the outside, it's very easy to make those guys miss. So if I know that they're shading underneath, or if I think they are, I'm kind of keeping my eye out for that. If I recognize them shading underneath, I'm going to the corner route if I 100% know it. But if you kind of panic and maybe you miss your read, you know that you still have the in route over the middle, and if they clamp down on that, then you just go to the tight end. Now let's go to a cover two. So basic cover two, gonna work the same way. Again, we're dinking dunking them underneath. That's what we're looking to do. you know, pick up our easy yards here. You see there, he got a bad animation and we still were able to get 7 yards. Go back to the cover two here. So, I mean, and until you force them to shade underneath, this is what you do. You just say, okay, you know, how do you want to do it? You know, we can dink and dunk this down the field slow. The drag against the cover two is going to actually be better than the cover three. You're going to probably pick up right there. We got like 7 or 8. We could have probably got 10 if we would have threw it a second later. So that's really up to you. You know, if you want to wait a little bit longer on it, if you know they're like playing a lot of cover two, you can do that. But just again, very easy way to dink and dunk them. And most people are not going to shade underneath against a cover two or in a cover two, because that just leaves them way too vulnerable if they do that. So again, we go cover two, we shade underneath. Again, you probably won't see this very much, but if they do that, you know, again, you can still hit this in route over the middle. Again, I mean, they're shaded underneath in a cover two and we still got 7 yards. Like, that's really, for me, what makes this play in particular so good, is because usually when you shade underneath, you wouldn't be able to hit either the drag or the in route. Both of them would be locked up. But with this play, just with the way the routes develop, it's there. And again, if they were shade underneath, okay, well, we take the corner route and we're going to get huge yards. So shading underneath is never going to be the answer against this. Now, what if they were to go, actually, let's go back to cover two, because something else people like to do, you know, in cover two is drop this middle linebacker back in the deep blue. That's really better for us because there's nothing going to that part of the field. So if they're doing that, they're literally just taking another guy, you know, out of the area for us. They're just making it easy for us. And then, you know, we could, again, still hit the slant, or excuse me, the in route underneath. But then what also happens is, you're going to notice here, is the tight end's going to open up more if they play that style of a cover two, because you see that middle linebacker is dropping off into nowhere. That's not helping him on this play. And then you see we did hit the in route. Of course, we had the drag coming open under here too, but also over the deep middle. Now we have 3 routes. So if they're playing that style of cover two, then quite honestly, they're putting themselves in a bad situation. And a lot of people will do that. So let's show it. Let's actually hit the route this time just to be thorough and show it. Again, same setup, block, in route the X, motion them over, and you see, I mean, like, so either style of cover two they want to give you, that's on them. They're gonna mess up there if they do that. So if they go man defense, love this play against man too. First and foremost, corner route. If you know they're playing man, I mean, this corner route is dusting anybody. And of course, Antonio Brown's there. Best receiver, best route running, so it's even better. But you don't even need crazy route running for this corner route, because it, you notice most corner routes in the game have a slow, like a very slow cut. This one cuts extremely quick and sharp. This is how all the corner routes used to cut, you know, years back. Now, sometimes you have corner routes that are considered bad corner routes, or they kind of round off a little bit more, and that kind of takes away the opportunity to get good separation. This corner route is not that. Now, again, we have underneath stuff, of course. You have the in route. I mean, and that's, you know, AJ Bouye on him, who's a pretty good cornerback, to say the least. That's Washington, who, you know, on the game, he's not a crazy, you know, good wide receiver like that. And he was still able to get, you know, really good separation on that motion. Like, you see what happens, and this was what the motion does a lot of times, is when they hit the cut right here, you see how Bouye kind of froze just for a second. And that just allows us to get huge separation. And then, of course, look, we have Schuster underneath on the drag crossing over. That's Ramsey chasing him. You're not going to find a better corner in Regs than Ramsey. And then, you know, he's still getting dusted like that. And then over the middle, you have the tight end, the speed end of the tight end. He's getting separation. So you literally have all 4 guys opening against man. If you're playing someone that wants man, you have corner, you have drag, you have the in route, and you have the tight end. I mean, you really can't ask for anything better than that. And, of course, this isn't the only play you'd want to run out of this. There's other good plays in this formation. Obviously, you know, mix in the run just to keep them honest when you want to run something like this. Of course, you know, we just got stuff there. But I'm just saying, obviously, mix other stuff in. You don't want to just run one play. But I'm just showing you how effective one simple play can be versus all of the basic coverages in the game. Again, like, even if they want to send, like, blitzes at you, you know, a cover two, you know, corner blitz or something off the edge, a heavy blitz. Sometimes people like to blitz 6 this year. They like to kind of come 2 guys off the edge. Yes, you're going to have to get rid of the ball a little bit quicker, but they're literally throwing, you know, like, they're blitzing, like, from the areas that you're trying to attack. So you're picking up 8 to 10 yards simply by just throwing it where they're vacating. So all in all, very simple play, nothing crazy, nothing over the top, but just something that simple can be that effective. Versus regular zone man and even shaded zones that normally would take away some of these routes, doesn't work on this play. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video and found it helpful. If you did, as always, just drop a like, comment, subscribe. and I will see you guys next time.